Hey everyone, welcome back to .NET MAUI 101. I'm your host Gerald, and in this episode we're going to learn how to create that consistent look throughout your app with styles. Now, if you've been working with .NET MAUI applications, you probably know that you have numerous styling options on buttons, on labels, on all the visual elements. You can set text colors, you can set background colors, you can set gradients if that's what you want. You can do all these kinds of crazy things. But of course, we're developers and we don't like to repeat ourselves. So that is where styles come in. With styles, you can create styles that you can apply throughout your whole application, either implicitly, explicitly, on all of your visual elements so that your look will have that consistent look throughout your whole application. Let's dive in and see how that actually works. Here we have just a file new .NET MAUI application, which is running on Windows. Nothing has been changed. This is just a default template, a little .NET bot waving at you saying hello world. And here is where we're going to see how to apply styles. So let me stop running this actually. And here in our main page.xaml on the content page, what we're going to do is add a resources node. So here we are. And inside of those resources, we need to specify a resource dictionary. So inside of that resource dictionary, you can now start defining styles. So this style, we have it right here. We need to specify a target type, which is the visual element that is going to be this style consumer, basically. So let's say label for here. It can be a button. It can be anything, collection view, you name it. You can input any target type here as well. And there is immediately an important thing here. If you want to also apply these styles to things that inherit from your label, so maybe you've created your own label, then you want to say also apply to derived types. You also want to do that. But that is something for you, a little homework for you to figure out. Label, and then we can say X key, we can give it a name, is label style. So let's do that. And now we have created our style. And inside of the style, we can work with setters. And each setter is going to set a property on our label in this case. Or if you defined it for a button, you can do it for a button. So we're going to do setter, and we're going to specify property. And you can see, because we have that target type, the IntelliSense will already start helping us with the property here. So here we see all the properties that are on a label, and we can say text color, and we can set the value for that. And because we know it's the property text color, we can also now specify which value IntelliSense will help us with that. So let's say it to fuchsia, and then we can specify all the setters that we want here, basically. So we can do setter property, and we can say font size. So we can also set the font size, and you can set all the properties that you want here. So let's set this to 32, close this one, and now we have defined our first style. So let's go actually find a label here down here, the hello world one, and what we're going to do is say style is, and then we're going to specify static resource, and you can see it already comes up with the label style. So it already knows that we have this style, and we can apply the label style. Now, if we do that, if we save this and I run this on the Windows machine again, you should see that this label now has a fuchsia color and a font size of 32. Maybe it already had 32. Yeah, it already had. So we're not going to see much change there, but it already had the font size. And this is kind of like interesting also in the in terms of like how this all kind of like cascades, because the styles can cascade, right? So this kind of like style will not have precedence whenever you set the property right here. So you can also kind of like override properties depending on how close you get to the label, basically. So if we set this font size to something different, it's going to be overwritten here with this font size here as well, kind of like how it works on the web and with CSS as well. So you can see we have this hello color now with a fuchsia color. But this is known as a explicit style, because we have to explicitly say style is this style. What if you don't want to do that? What if you want to make all of your labels a certain color just because that is whatever your styling is? So you can remove this style right here. And what you then need to do is remove this key. And whenever you do, we've set it as an implicit style. And because I'm using XAML hot reload, it already automatically updated my running app. So you can see that now all the labels, which is two in this case, now have this fuchsia color. So that is how you can create explicit and implicit styles. Just specify or not specify the key, and you can do those keys on the control that you actually want to. So let's stop this. So this only works for like the scope of this page, right? This only works for the labels on this page, which is fine, but you probably want to have this consistent look and feel throughout your whole application. So what we can do is take this style, we're just gonna copy this, and we're going to go to our Solution Explorer, and we're going to go to our app.xaml. Here you can see we already have the application.resources, a resource dictionary, and we actually have merged dictionaries. Now that is something a little bit more advanced. If you want to know more about that, please let me know down in the comments. But I'm going to add another resource dictionary here, resource dictionary, and you can then paste your style in here. And now suddenly it is something that works throughout your whole application. So now all the labels in our application will have this fuchsia text color. So the interesting thing, if you want to explore more, we have these resource dictionaries here. You can see the colors and the styles, which is something that is provided with the file new .NET MAUI application template right now. So you can just go here to your resources, your styles, and you have all these kinds of styles for all the controls, basically. So there's a lot of crazy stuff in here, also making difference between like light theme and dark theme. That's definitely something that you can do as well. So here you can kind of like tweak the styles that you have in here as well. Also, visual state group, all that kind of advanced stuff. If that is something that you want to know more in this .NET MAUI 101 series, please let me know down below in the comments. And just like that, you have learned how to create a consistent look for your .NET MAUI application by using styles and by putting them in resource dictionaries. You don't have to duplicate all your style everywhere. And if you make use of that correctly, then you can write less code and still have amazing looking .NET MAUI applications. Now, who doesn't like that? Now, if you've seen some concept fly by that I didn't really touch upon, then make sure to let me know down in the comments so I can include it in this .NET MAUI 101 series. But make sure before you do that it's not already on this .NET MAUI 101 playlist, and make sure that you click this button so that you're subscribed to my channel and you'll be notified of new content automatically. See you for the next one.